So this is the KBRL Ranch, right here on the Sun River. See someone over there. I just arrived on horseback. We're gonna cross the bridge here shortly. Just waiting for Dick to make sure that he can close the gate. Okay, this is the Sun River outflow. Goes into Gibson Reservoir. Crystal clear water. Big pool. Here we are at our second camp. We're up above this little gorge here, but we're going to get in the water downstream and then, who knows, maybe go swimming in there, but basically we try to work our way upstream and see what's above up there. Certainly there'll be some big fish down in the below the falls pretty much, but there should be fish all through here actually. And I'm guessing that's, I don't know, 8 feet deep down there. So, gorgeous campsite.
It's hot, though, really hot.
And here we are, you know, there's a fire pit there where we'll eat. And we're just relaxing in the shade until the heat goes away. And then we'll sleep somewhere up in there, find away from where we're cooking.
Good. Nice. Got.
Hey, it's the third fish I caught on a little grasshopper. Not too big, but it's sure good eating if we wanted to. Okay. To have an early night sleeping on the edge of this canyon. Everybody's trying to find as level a spot as they can. Dick's there between a couple rocks. Don's got a good spot, it looks like. Leif and Gunnar are over here. They haven't got everything together yet. But, you know, it's never perfectly level. I have to make sure I don't get up in the middle of the night and walk over the cliff over here. Yeah, here we are. We've had another great night. Good night fishing. Lots of laughter, camaraderie, education for Gunnar. But it's a beautiful morning. I don't know, it's about 9 o'clock and we're trying to beat the heat a little bit. And we're just entering the Bob Marshall Wilderness. Did he get off? I think JP's caught. That's like your fourth fish, right?
That was my fifth.
Awesome. Unreal. It's a beautiful hole right there. Hey, that's a good hole. JP caught 7 fish out of this hole, so Leif's now trying it. A few of the fish have already been stung. I heard that, Gunner. By yourself, you caught 2 fish. Pretty awesome.
That was a good-sized fish.
Oh, great.
By the way, we saw a monster jump basically right there.
Really? Wow.
I can't feel my toes in.
Well, this is morning 4, and the boys got up early and went fishing. Gunner caught 4, got a big rainbow. Jay got 4 more fish, so he's leading the pack. Don caught a fish, and Grandpa was sleeping. Well, Don and I are taking a rest. We're coming up towards Moose Creek. And Don and I, we're taking it slow and easy, like the old bulls do. Here come the young bucks. Dick left early, so he's way up in front of us, but going really slow.
Howdy.
Hey, guys.
How you doing there, Gunner? You feeling it?
Yeah. Well, have a seat for a minute.
It would knock you on your ass.
Uh-huh. Holy crud. It's like, ew.
Don took all the bullets out of the gun just to let Gunner know how heavy the gun is. Plus the bullets, which Don loaded by himself.
They're like 1 pound each.
Jeez.
Yeah. And they are heavy.
The total weight of that gun
plus amazing. The
bullets.
You forget how heavy that is.
Yeah. You just have that strapped to your chest. You gotta be tough to hold that.
Jeez Louise.
Feel this thing.
That must be 4 pounds or something.
Just like,
almost 8.
8 pounds.
Holy
look at the size
boy.
Of this. And Don loaded each of these.
Is that the gun you made?
No.
It's just so beautiful and so just perfect. All these trees are just...
Yeah, it's just cool.
You don't see this ever.
And then you see these giant boulders hidden amongst...
Hey, you think that's a boulder?
Go climb it.
Whoa. I think I will.
You will. Come on. I'll get a photo.
Take it.
Yeah, drop your pack. It's just cool.
Take my bear spray.
You don't need it. Just drop your pack.
This is gonna feel amazing.
Trees are getting shorter. The camera can see you.
couple pictures.
Just got hit with a little rain shower, but we saw the clouds coming, and both of the young boys and Dick and I, the old bucks, got the tent up before it started raining. So we're gonna wait till it calms down. Hopefully it will calm down. We're gonna have dinner out by the river about 100 yards from where we're sleeping here.
What time is it, about 4:30, 5 o'clock?
Dick and I are snug inside of our tent here. You can hear the rain. Thunder in the background.
Look outside.
Oh, it's getting cold in here.
It is pouring down rain. It is so stormy. Lightning, thunder. The rain is leaking in that side of the tent.
My food!
Your food's fine. Just leave it. It is pouring.
A lot of lightning, thunder.
It's awesome. And, well, we're stuck in this tent.
Grandpa and Dick are in the other tent.
I almost want to open it up and look. Ooh, there was thunder.
We've been getting a lot.
We just made it through a hell of a rain, lightning, thunderstorm. I don't know if you can see it, but there's a rainbow over there. And we're all having dinner now that it's a little bit sunny, even though it's still raining on us. Yay. We're having chicken curry tonight.
Well, it's day 5. Hey, Gunner, were you the first one up?
No, last.
Everybody else has already got their breakfast handled. Yeah, that bear. It's coming after you last night.
Yeah. We got scared it out with the gun.
It came to our tent first.
Yeah.
And your grandpa scared it away and went over to your tent.
Yeah, breakfast this morning. You can see the sky. It's pretty clear this morning, so. Yeah, a ton of thunder and lightning, and of course the thunder reverberates big time in the canyon.
Boom, boom, boom.
Yeah, really loud. Were you scared last night?
Only of the bear.
Only of the bear, okay.
Here we are, Moose Creek. We found a good access point, and we got Gunner all worked up with his fly. He ties his own flies now, puts his own rod together, and he's off looking for some holes. But look how beautiful this creek is, out in the middle of the wilderness, Montana. Oh my gosh, heaven on earth. And our camp is about a half mile up this creek. But we decided to walk up it, just walk up the creek, fish, and then theoretically we run into our other people who are sitting around camp. So the fish, because this is a small creek, the fish typically aren't in this fast water, they're gonna be in holes. That's okay, but it's just be careful of the brush and the logs. I mean, that's not a bad hole, but it's a little fast in terms of the water. Truly heaven on earth. So JP's found a hole, Gunner, so we want to stay away from his hole. We don't want to scare his fish, so we'll probably stand back. There might be fish there. Tough to get to them where the slow water is. Okay, yeah, stay right, follow this shallow ridge line. And Gunner has 9 fish. Yeah, well, JP's been fishing a lot longer than you have, Gunner. He's bound to be a better fisherman. But you're doing a hell of a job. You'll get there in no time. Yep. Hey Gunner, one of the things I think I want you to do is watch how JP high sticks in this water. So get away from JP. Got a fire pit here, a hot spot for the pan. Little tiny fire to do fish tacos. With the wind blowing, we are very sensitive to it.
This is the best part, the cooking.
Yeah. We do have some clouds coming in. Some kind of fry pan. We got gluten-free tacos, have some oil, spatula. Getting the pan with oil hot enough so that the fish can fry. Hey, here's the wild trout that we're going to cook.
How's that pan feeling? Doesn't look hot enough.
Couple of master chefs at work. Good job, guys.
Oh boy, hold on.
Yeah. You want me to set it?
Yeah, set it on the side. Set it on the side of the tinfoil. There you go. Thank you.
Wow. Tortilla.
Rick. Just toast one side.
Rick the great fisherman.
Pardon?
Rick the great fisherman.
Well, we got here and got to focus. It wasn't bushwhacking with a backpack. Wow. Nathan busy deboning. JP's the tortilla guy. Wow. Great fireplace.
The last time we had this meal.
Yep.
I don't think you'd be able to.
Good night, Gunner. Wave. Hey, we're going. This is night. Is this night 5?
Yeah. Halfway.
Okay.
Jeez, you didn't think you'd last this long, did you?
Dick's in the tent. And they're over there tending the fire, and they'll be back shortly. I got Gunner tucked in.
Tending the fire, you know how that goes. I know some fire and booze stories that last a long time.
Okay. Pretty sunset, though. That's, I'll check in a minute.
Monday, we just stopped for a first break at 5.3 miles at 11:20. We're about a mile from the Chinese Wall. We're staying at the base tonight. Beautiful country. We should be less than an eighth of a mile from the place they camped in 2020. I'm going to be heading down the river shortly. Waters of Moose Creek, a low kind of wall.
Well, I don't know how and I don't know why, but when something's living where you can't see die, you feel feel like laughing, but you start to cry. I don't know how and I don't know why. Well, I don't have many and I don't have much. In fact, I don't have any, but I got enough. 'Cause I know those eyes and I know that touch. I don't have many and I don't have much. Oh, darling, my heart's on fire. Oh, darling, my heart's on fire. Oh, darling, my heart's on fire.
Well, we made it to the meadow up here. And that is the Chinese Wall and the Continental Divide. We're at about 7,000 feet. At its highest point is, I think, around 7,900 to 8,000. The boys are up there waiting for us. Mother Nature has a grand plan. As we're on the lower tectonic plate, and it'll go underneath this one over millennia and be recycled. Come out somewhere on Earth.
But when something's living, we can't
a new continent.
You feel like laughing, but you start to cry.
There they are, hanging out. I was just keeping Dick company on the way up. There's Dick.
Well, I don't have many and I don't have much. In fact, I don't have any, but I got enough. 'Cause I know those eyes and I know that touch.
This video will not do justice. But we're in one of the meadows. We're going to get right up next to the wall. And there's some amazing shots, but this at least gives you some perspective. How's it going, Dick? Got a video. Say hi.
Hi. Where's my Geritol? I need a transfusion.
Yeah, it's really, this is the payoff. And we're going to be hiking over that left side peak. There's a trail under the wall there.
Well, I don't know how and I don't know why. But when something's living, we can't see die. You feel like laughing, but you start to cry. I don't know how and I don't know why. Well, I don't have me.
Yeah, we're over the pass. Now heading all downhill.
In fact, I don't have any, but
for the most part.
'Cause I know those eyes and I know that touch. I don't have me. Don't have much.
And that wall just keeps going and going and going. This whole thing goes for miles and miles. 8,400 feet.
Oh, darling, my heart's on fire for you. Well, I don't know where and I don't know when, but I know we'll be lovers again. See you someday before the end.
Well, for the third day in a row, it's beginning pelted with real heavy rain. The forecast today was 50% starting at 2 o'clock, and much hear the thunder and lightning. Last forecast was 50%, but I had my rain gear, and matter of fact, I wore my rain pants and had my rain jacket, but it didn't rain till about 8 or 9 at night. But better now than during the day when we're hiking. This is the third day of the trip. We're in the West Fork Sun River drainage. We've been in the woods all morning. We just came out to first opening where you can get some, see the vistas. Sprinkled a little bit this morning, but pleasant hiking, about 60 degrees. Guys have done 7 miles since breakfast. Is not even noon yet. It's like a couple of racehorses trying to keep up with going through the mountains. This is, we've been in the deep woods, not too many areas where the fire burn was open where you could look around. We just walked by a big grizzly bear scrape on a tree. Beautiful country, wild. We just finished our lunch at the 7 3/4 mile marker. We're gonna try to go, we're gonna go 12 miles today before we stop. And it's pretty wild, wide open country. We've gone about 9.5 miles so far, aiming for 12. The terrain looks like at about the 9.5 mile point. We're at
there's 10 miles
in today. We're looking at the deer down at the bottom, as well as the bald eagle sitting in the tree. And looks like excellent fishing area.
Last couple of days, heading out of the bob. Just keep going.
500 miles an hour.
It's Thursday, and we're gonna camp down on the river. We camped up there about 1.5-2 miles. Really beautiful. Quite the valley here. We're looking at the South Fork of the Sun River.
Gunner caught a fish. Might be a good size one. Tip up, reel, reel, reel. You got it, buddy, he's tiring out. Just slowly, but if he runs, let him take the line. Nice fish. Hold on, let's keep him in the water. Nice job.
He just dug it.
Calm down, buddy.
Nice size cutthroat. Look at that.
It's day 9, Thursday. And we only have about, I think, 7 miles for the car. We're at a beautiful campsite here, just on the outskirts of the Bob Marshall. We're taking a break. It's all grassy in here. Having a snack. We came from way up in the mountains there, but you can see how lovely it is here with the trees. Maybe quaking aspen, I'm not sure. But you can see the ranch hands nearby, or someone built a way to get across, and that would be a beautiful fishing hole over there. Yeah, really nice. We're not going to fish until we get to the, this is still the South Fork, and it meets up with the North Fork of the Sun, and then together they flow into the Gibson Reservoir, where we're going to see if we can do some fishing in the combined waters. Looks like Don's got a good seat there. Dick's checking out his GPS location. Great day so far.
That is disgusting.
Wow, we hiked up that North Fork of the Sun River. It was crystal clear. And it's coming down this dirty brown now.
It's beautiful, but it's kind of...
Compared to this South Fork, which is absolutely crystal clear.
Amazing fishing.
Crazy.
Perfect. That's perfect. Look at that.
Pretty good.
Oh, good job.
That's pretty good.
Last day, Mother Nature made her presence known. It lightened and thundered and rained heavy,
good
heavy,
morning.
Heavy. It really pounded us last night, but we were in our tents. And it really didn't start raining until we went to bed, but it rained all night. And the water now has changed to a murky, drab, olive green, murky. The South Fork used to be last night, it was clear. But boy, the water has risen, probably 3-4 feet. We're gonna have breakfast, and then we're gonna make our way to the car.
Which is six and a half miles away?
Yeah, 6 or 7, and JP and Don and Leif were down there by the river. I didn't want to walk down there, so we're going to have our coffee near the tent. Dick's got his rain gear on, rain pants on. He's prepared.
And it quit raining.
Yeah, and it quit raining. And we've got our coffee.
Chris and Bob.
Okay, go for it. I can't see the... Oh, yeah. Let me zoom in. No more. It's cold. Wow. Completely brown, muddy, muddy water. Wow. The sun's trying to come out, but let's see. Yeah, this is the same river we were fishing and had crystal clear water. Look at that. Storm Mother Nature.
Well, I don't know how and I don't know why, but when something's living where you can't see die, you feel like laughing but you start to cry. I don't know how and I don't know why. Well, I don't have many and I don't have much. In fact, I don't have any, but I got enough. 'Cause I know those eyes and I know that touch. I don't have many and I don't have much. Oh, darling, my heart's on fire. Darling, my heart's on fire. Oh, darling, my heart's on fire.